Hi everyone and welcome back. So in previous videos we talked about a lot of different aspects about JavaScript and related questions in interviews. Like they can ask you about any basic JavaScript question, so you should be doing enough preparation before going through the interviews. So in this video we are going to talk about what is curry function. So in the definition I will just tell you, it is a technique for converting a function call with n argument into a chain of n function. I just got this definition from web. Okay, let's try to understand it. So curry function always returns another function. So this is a simple function, right? So what we are doing here is add function taking x and then returning another function which is taking argument y and then x plus y. If I just try to write it, simple function is, it's something like this. Here I have function add1 which is taking v as an argument and I'm returning a plus b. Right, something like this. This add function is returning add1 and add1 is so, and both the functions are taking an argument a plus b and finally we are returning a plus b. If you convert this, then the curry function representation will be like this. Right, same code with the arrow function. Like if I talk about the simple example with curry or without curry function. So this is with curry function and the same code when we try to write it without curry function using simple functions without using arrow function, right? So the curry function same implementation look like this, and we are familiar with this and also this with also. So you can actually keep increasing the chain and you can just say x plus y plus z. In that case, there will be another function which is being returned by this. This should be z, okay? Something like this. So this is the same representation. So in order to use our curry function, we have to call it a bit differently. How we are calling it? So const a1, I will be calling add with passing argument, okay, 1. Then const a2, I will be calling a1 passing argument 2. Then const a3 passing the argument calling the a2. So this is actually a chain expression I'm calling, right? Can I make it a little shorter and sweeter? So const x equal to, I can do add, okay, let's call it in a chain 1 2 and 3. This is also the same thing which I'm doing in the three different lines, right? So it's like I'm creating a chain and I'm calling the function which is being written by another function which is being written by another function. So it can be a big chain. I mean, this is how the curry functions, and if it also talks about the concept of closure, how we are able to return outer function and still the inner function is holding the value of that, right? So if you talk about this, this function, innermost function is having the xy in the closure of itself, right? This is the innermost function. With the help of closure, it has access to the y and x, even when the y function, outer function and the outermost function has already returned the values, right? So this is about curry function, and sometimes this is asked in the interviews.